हेलो गाइस, माय नेम इज़ हरदविंदर। वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द IGCSE पेपर्स वेब ऑथिंग पार्ट। वी विल डाउनलोड अ पेपर एंड विल सॉल्व वेब ऑथरिंग पार्ट ऑफ वेब पेज एंड CSS। लेट अस स्टार्ट। फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज योर असाइनमेंट। बाय क्लिकिंग हियर यू कैन डाउनलोड योर पेपर along with the source code. Yes, this is the paper. Yes, copy your this assignment on desktop. After copying, you have to extract it. Click and extract here, because this is zip file and this is a paper, and we have to solve this question paper 31. This is 31, and this is a source file of paper 31. We need these two, this file and this folder. Copy these both, keep them on desktop, and you need to extract this folder also. Extract. Yes, click here and extract it. Now this is a source file and this is a question paper. So let us start with the web authoring part. This is the first part, is spreadsheet, and we will start with the task 4, web page. So as this task 4 is of 25 marks, maximum marks this contains. Out of the 80, this task 4 only, contains 25 marks. So that's too important. Let us learn it. A trainee has started to create a style sheet for Super Disc sales. The style sheet is not finished and contains a number of errors. You are going to edit the style sheet. All color codes must be in hexadecimal. Make sure that you use the most efficient method. Heading style H4, H5 and H6 will not be used, so do not need defining. Make sure that your style sheet contains no HTML. You have to just write the CSS code, not a HTML code. Open this style sheet, and specifications for this style sheet are given. These are the specifications. Correct and complete this style sheet using the information above. Place your name, center number and candidate number as the comment at the start of the style sheet. Save this style sheet, use the name this and follow your candidate number for the example this, and then you will have to keep the evidence of that. After that, this 2 marks task again will have to do. So firstly, we need to complete this. So first of all, you have to open this 193style.css. So let us open this source file and open this file. They are told open in notepad++. That's too easy. After opening it, we have to set it proper way. This is not in a proper formatting, means that this file is not a correct. The completely we have to make the new one. We will open this notepad coding and question paper side by side. This is your question paper. We will open both the things side by side so that we can easily solve it. Where is that? This part we were solving. This is not in a proper formatting, so completely delete it and we will make a new one. So firstly, we need to make a table and start the bracket. The first specification is position aligned within the browser window. Center aligned means the table which we will create, that must be in a center, means left margin and right margin should be automatic, and that should be in a center. So you can set the margins, margin left is equal to auto, margin right also auto, and width should be 1200 pixels wide. So set the width 1200 pixel and border collapse, not collapse, border collapse means we need to show the separate borders, we will not collapse the borders. So give the value separator. I think you know, we have learned in a previous class also, this is a property and this is a value of that property. You know how to define these tags, these attributes in CSS. You have already learned, I hope, for that. You need to learn these properties, means table properties you have to learn and their values. Only then you can solve it very well. So as we have already learned, if we want to keep the left and right margin automatic, means we want to keep them in a center, so we can give the margin left auto and margin right auto. And this width 12 pixel wide, we need the table bed. And border collapse means we want to show separate borders for every column and every row. So that's why we have set it as separate. Otherwise, if we don't want to show different border for the two columns, we can make the border collapse as a collapse. So here we need a separate that should be visible. So they have asked us width 2 pixel solid and border color. So now border first value is for its thickness, which is 2 pixel, means width. Then a solid, and then they want color. The third property, third value of this property is color. So that should be in a hexadecimal. That's why we put a hash 8083x0. This is a color code. So now table is complete. Then table data means TD. We have to set the properties of TD. Cell padding. Padding, you know, the space between a cell. And the position of a text between a cell at top, bottom, right, left, all the between the cells, the spaces, that is called a padding. They are saying top padding we need 8 pixels. So padding top, that is 8 pixel. Padding left we need 20 pixel. Padding right, again 20 pixel. And border should be visible, it will automatically be visible. And borders, border, these properties should be 2 pixel wide, solid, and color that is 8083x0. You know, after defining every property in a CSS of any attribute, for defining any property, after defining every property, we need to put the semicolon. You know this thing, I think. Table data properties we have set. Now table headings, all headings means h1, h2, h3. I think only 3 headings are there in this table. For all of them, there are common properties. So first we can write h1, comma h2, comma h3. There are 3 headings, there are common properties for them. The color of these 3 borders is blue 00, red ff, and green ff. Students, keep in mind, we write the color in RGB form. R means red, G means green, and B means blue. So firstly we will write the code of R is red, ff, which they have told ff. G means green, again that is ff, and then blue, which is 00. So set it color. Then they have asked for the font family. Font means font, which type of font they want, Times New Roman, but if not available then Times, or if these fonts are not available then browser's default serif font. So we need to set the font property and this font family. So that is Times New Roman. That is not available, then Times, that is not available, then by default automatically serif font will automatically display, the browser will display. These are the common properties of 3 headings. If we want the separate headings, h1's properties are there, 48 points high, means its size should be 48 points. For writing a size, we need to write the font font size. Then test line, that is right. Then H2, they have asked 24 point high, font size 24 point. Then H3, 18 point high, font size is 18 point high. And font weight, so we need to set font weight. Font weight, that is bold. So we have set all these properties. We have covered this. By mistake, I have closed that. Open it again. Where was the question paper? It's on the desktop. Yes, we have set all these properties, correct and complete the style sheet using information above. We have corrected place your name, center number and candidate number as a comment in the start of the style sheet. We have to set our in the starting. We can give the comments like this: name Hardevinder Singh, center number N0001, code suppose there are 999. So this 4 times 9. Save your style sheet. Use the file name styles 193 styles followed by candidate number, for the example 193 styles 4 times 9.css. So .css is already written. So you need to write the candidate number 4 times 9, 1, 2, 3, 4. So save this file in source. This 25 marks task we have completed. Let's move further. Take a screenshot showing the contents of your style sheet and place them in your evidence document. Make sure that your contents are easy to read and file name is clearly visible. So we have to take the screenshot of this. Take a screenshot. Select the grab. Take its screenshot. So on the desktop, give the name CSS file. I have taken the same. You can put in your evidence document. Open the web page n19webpage.html in your web authoring package, means any browser. No, not in web authoring package, means in Notepad++. Right? We are using replace the test a candidate Z999. 4 times 9 with your name, center number and candidate number. Attach the style sheet SSD style.css to its web page. Attach the style sheet use creator step 17 on your web page so that it has a higher priority than style sheet DD style1.css. Save the web page, display the web page in your browser. Make sure all the pages can be seen, all the text can be easily read and address bar is visible. Take a screenshot of web page in your browser and place it in your evidence document. Display the HTML source in your editor. Take a copy of HTML source and place this in your evidence document. So let us complete this task. We have to open n19webpage.html. So we have already opened this n19. We have to open which one? This. Open in your Notepad++. This open. After that, they have told us to replace here web page created by also design a candidate. A candidate means your name. Suppose Hardevinder Singh. And your candidate number, suppose that is N0001. this is him. So after that they have told attach the style sheet SST style CSS1. This style sheet we have to attach. Copy, I can copy it. In the head section we can write here to attach style sheet, the code is REL rel. So for that you will have to write rel first, then link. First you will have to write link. And that is style sheet. Then H, then type. Type. Test CSS, then href, then give the name of that CSS file which I have already copied. Now paste it, and this way that style sheet has been attached with this HTML page. So after that they have told us attach another style sheet which we have made now. That style sheet also we have to attach with this in created in step 17 on your web page, so that it is higher priority. Higher priority means we will attach it after that. Which we will attach the later, that will be a high priority. Priority which we have earlier, that will be having a lower priority. So now after that we will have to attach the style sheet which we have created just in the previous step, that 25 marks question. Then the code, you have to memorize this code, style sheet type equal to test CSS href. So let us copy the name of that. This is a file, this file we have to attach. So we can copy this file name and then close it and then save it. After that save the web page, display web page in your all browsers and the page can be seen, everything. So save this file. Now let us check that file, is that working, has the style sheets been attached or not. So this is where is this page, open in web browser. This style sheet has been attached properly and is doing very well. So students, we need to take its screenshot. It should be fully visible. So take a screenshot, select, give the name web page, save it. So same you can paste in your evidence document. Hope you have learned this, how to create. It's very important. 25 mark plus 2, 27 marks paper out of 80 we have covered with this. It's too easy, students. So you have to learn CSS very carefully. It's too easy to get the marks. Thank you. Thank you very much.